guys, so recently, I haven't mentioned this in my YouTube channel, but like a month ago or 2 months ago, I don't really remember exactly when, but I have a PS Vita. And I've been wanting this handheld device for a fairly long time, but it's an expensive device, so I've been holding off on it. But somehow I got the impulse to kind of eBay it, and I got it for a very reasonable price. I don't remember exactly how much I got it for, but it's the amount, the money that I paid for PS Vita is remarkably cheaper than if I buy it, you know, new on retail. So I have a PS Vita, and when I bought it, when I eBayed it, it also came with four games, which I thought was pretty awesome. It came with the Resistance Burning Skies, Sly Cooper Thieves in Time, so the new Sly Cooper, Michael Jackson Experience, which I don't care about, and what was the last game? I think it was some kind of sports game of some sort. But those are the four games that came with it. And maybe I'll talk about the PlayStation Vita itself in another video. But this video I wanted to talk about Killzone Mercenary. So Resistance Burning Sky is pretty much the first PS Vita game I played. So it's also the first first-person shooter experience that was released on the Vita. Was it actually? Or did Black Ops 2 declassified come first? I'm not actually sure on that. You can fact check me on that. But yeah, I never played Call of Duty Black Ops 2 declassified myself, so I don't really know how that experience would compare to Resistance Burning Sky or Killzone Mercenary or what have you. But Resistance Burning Sky was kind of meh. Like it wasn't a bad game. It's disappointing compared to the pedigree of the entire franchise as a whole. It's not necessarily a bad game, but it's not like a really great game. It's just kind of a game you pop in and you just play for 5 hours and that's kind of it. I do like, there are things about it that I really like. Like the secondary fire, you use the touch screen, and that adds kind of a new dynamic to this game. But it's a very scaled down experience, because Resistance is, all three games really are really grand experience in some ways. You know, a lot of enemies, large open areas that you fight in and whatnot, especially 2, Resistance 2. Resistance 3 has some of those moments too, but yeah, it's just kind of meh, you know. So like, Killzone Mercenary on the PlayStation Vita is arguably the best PlayStation, the first best first-person shooter game on that platform. But when you have competitors, which are Resistance, Burning Skies, and Call of Duty Black Ops 2 Declassified, that is not saying much, you know. Being the best first-person shooter on the Vita isn't really much of a title, right? But that said, I do want to say Killzone Mercenary is a fantastic game. Like, even just if this was released on a regular console, you know, it wouldn't amount to as, it wouldn't be that big of a deal. It's just another shooter, whatnot. But I think it does, I don't know, I'm really floored by this game. And in some ways, much more than the console Killzone games, which is saying something. You know, because the console Killzone games, especially Killzone 2, like, I have enormous respect, enormous appreciation for. And Killzone Mercenary really adds to that kind of fan appreciation I have for the series, although Killzone 3 kind of made me gripe a lot, especially the single-player campaign. But, you know, whatever, that was a fun experience. But Killzone Mercenary really builds on all of that and kind of combines all the console Killzone experiences and kind of puts it in there, which I thought was really, like, the storytelling aspect to it is a really nice touch. It really spans the events from Killzone 2, Killzone 1 to the end of Killzone 2, which is really cool. Like, I get to see there are some cutscene moments from the first Killzone game that are in here. And the experience is extremely varied. You know, I love the level design of this game, and it's highly replayable. This is probably, like, the most replayable Killzone game. Because, you know, Killzone 2, you can play it, you know, the single-player campaign, and then you'll go back to it if you want to on a higher difficulty, but there's, like, no incentive to do that other than to just kind of enjoy the experience again, which I did. You know, Killzone 3 is a more a linear affair than the other Killzone games. So you experience it, and there's so many rail segment, like rail shooting segments, in Killzone 3, and vehicle segments and whatnot. Killzone Mercenary has those too, but like it really diversifies the experience. I don't know. I just love Killzone Mercenary. I think it's a really awesome game. You get to pick up your loadouts in the beginning of the mission. You know, which weapons you want to pick, and which weapons you pick has a dramatic impact on how you play the game. And there's also different abilities and different kind of what machines that you can wear. You touchpad. The controls are really fluid. And the graphics on this thing is amazing. This is definitely the best graphics I've ever experienced on a handheld. To me, you know, and I was really saying that, like, I don't know, like, it really is. It looks almost as good as, like, Killzone 2 and Killzone 3 on some parts. And when you begin the game, you're in Becta, so it's a very colorful atmosphere, which hasn't been really seen in the Killzone universe, except maybe Killzone Shadowfall. That's a PS4 game, you know? So, amazing graphics, amazing controls. Overall, like, this is a solid Killzone game. The only probably disappointing thing, you know, the only really, really subpar aspect of this game in comparison to the other games in the franchise is the multiplayer. It's very standard fare and typical. And the two other Killzone games on the PS3 and I don't know about PS4, I've never played Killzone Shadowfall. Probably won't for a long time because that requires that I get a PS4. And who knows when that'll happen. But Killzone 2 and Killzone 3, I love the multiplayer experience. It's like online multiplayer on Killzone 2 and Killzone 3, phenomenal, you know? So when you have the phenomenalness of the Killzone 2 and Killzone 3 multiplayer, yeah, compared to that, Killzone Mercenary is just kind of standard fare. It's kind of, I don't know, I think more effort was put into this game on the single player experience than the multiplayer. Doesn't have like the same class systems that Killzone multiplayer is known for. And just get to shoot around. They still try to add the Warzone thing where game types kind of change on the fly, but there's really only like four game types. I think there's technically five or six, but they just feel like three game types. You just go around shooting people, and the objectives that change on the fly are really it's not very team focused, this game. It's just kind of run around, shoot. No, and the amount of players that can happen per match is significantly lower too. Killzone 3 lowered the player count, but Killzone Mercenary is even lower than that, which is understandable considering it's a portable title. Considering it's on a platform where there's not that many install base, there's not much install base. You know, PlayStation Vita is still not selling very well as people would hope. You know, but yeah, multiplayer is meh, but I would have to say, you know, the single player experience is pretty amazing. It's definitely like, you know, I would, some moments, I think, really, like, I enjoyed Killzone Mercenary much more than Killzone 2 or Killzone 3 in many of the parts, and I replayed much of the levels, and stealth is such a amazing experience in Killzone Mercenary than compared to any of the Killzone franchise. The enemies are super smart, they flank you, like, so well. It's an extremely challenging game, especially on the hard difficulty, and accruing money and buying stuff. Like, it's an amazing, awesome experience. I just love this game, Killzone Mercenary, and it makes me feel so glad that I actually have a PS Vita. Even though the game's library, even at this point, is fairly limited, but PS Vita, when I have it, like, I'm always impressed by this handheld console. Like, it's such an awesome device to just have in my hands. I've never really felt this like amazing appreciation for a handheld like this before, and you know, just also like this is another digression, but PS Vita I think is also like really fantastic in that the digital games, the download games, and the indie games and the free to play games that you can play on this device is pretty remarkable. What Killzone Mercenary, like, pretty fantastic. First-person shooters are really, really hard to find on the handheld. And finally, one exists that is actually really, 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 really awesome to play.